Hello, in this video I'm going to show you how you can use the modular wall tool. So here I have the tool open and I have my parameters. So at the top we have our main size, so we can increase this so it's a wider one, or we can increase also here the height as well, or lower this if you want that. Then further we have different options, so I'm going to start out with my wall. Then with the wall I have different styles, so this is the default style, nothing special. We can go to a wood style, which will add these wooden planks. We can, for example, increase the amount in there. Then I can go here to a stone style, so it will generate a stone pattern here. You also have some seat in there and some more options. Then let's say I would like to add a door, so we can enable the door option here. Then we have the position of the door, we have the height of the door, we have the width, the amount of doors, we can also add a round door and so on. Then further we have a window, so I'm going to have to click on the plus icon here to add a window. I'm going to have to position this where I would like to have this. Then there is also a round option here as well, and we can then play around with the size afterwards. Then we have here the border setting. You can see that my border is now intersecting with my stones, so we can, for example, start boosting out the border like so, so it's not that intersecting anymore. Or we can decide to don't use the border or use different style, like we can use the stone border here, like it's now filled with these stones, which we can also like get some variation, like it's merging stones, we have some seed and so on. You also have the option to not show borders everywhere, so we have a few toggles here to add where you would like to see border. Then further here I have the bend option, so when I enable the bend, which is going to bend our model. So by default we have 90 degrees here, so we can go more or go less. So we can, for example, start creating a tower like so. We can also add extra divisions. So in some cases, when I would, for example, take the default wall, I would like to add some extra divisions to increase the smoothness in there, if you want that. Then further, we also have a taper mode. So I can here start squeezing the shape a bit. So that can also be quite interesting to use. We also have further here a capture region. So we can actually say more specifically where the bend is happening. So when we increase this, I can now here control the bend over here in this area. So it can be also useful if you need specific shape. Further, we have then the output. So this is the normals of the model, if you want to smoothen them. Then we have some basic vertex color. So the wall, door, border, and windows. You also have an advanced color, which is actually a gradient. So if I would just disable this, you will see all colors are just quite flat. But we can add a small gradient in there if you want to. And that's it for the modular wall tool.